The mission of the EPA may be to protect human health and the environment, but a congressman called it one of the most toxic places to work in the entire federal government.
One has to wonder if the EPA's culture and lack of accountability is a contributing factor to tragedies like the Volking mine spill or the Flint drinking water crisis.
The EPA's inspector general has closed more than 60 cases of employee misconduct over the last several months. One case involved an employee who stole and pawned thousands of dollars worth of government equipment. Another case involved an EPA contractor who was caught watching pornography on his government computer for up to 2 hours a day. But the case that angered House Republicans the most was a convicted child molester who remained on the EPA's payroll after the agency had learned of his conviction.
He received a cash settlement of $55,000, I believe. I'll have to check my notes.
The American people paid him $55,000 to walk away?
Yes.
But the focus of today's hearing was not what those employees did, it was how the EPA responded. The inspector general found that in many of these cases, the employees faced little or no disciplinary action.
Last year, 2015, how many people were fired from EPA?
I don't know. I can't find a single instance in which anyone was fired. They mostly retired.
What does it take to get fired from the EPA? What do you have to do? Do I have to kill somebody, or is it a little short of that?
It could be a little short of that, okay. Yes.
The EPA says it has made changes, and they're working. Changes like new limits on administrative leave and biweekly meetings to discuss current cases.
The isolated misconduct of a few does not reflect and must not overshadow the dedication and hard work of over 15,000 EPA employees.